Arrg, ahoy, mateys. This is Miss Jessie. I'm a librarian at the Central Library of the Buffalo and Erie County Public Library. And today I'm back with a special STEM Saturday challenge in honor of International Talk Like a Pirate Day. So today we're going to be building our own pirate ship to carry back the booty that we've collected on our voyages. I'm also going to show you some wonderful pirate books, and I have a special blog post today all about some more pirate fun. So let's start our adventure. So here I have some of the wonderful pirate picture books that we have here at the Central Library. If you search the library's catalog for pirate, you're going to find lots of wonderful titles to share with your families. One of my favorites is "No Pirates Allowed," said Library Lou. Do you think pirates can be in the library? Of course they can. The libraries are for everyone. I'm going to post these titles and some more on our library's blog post. I will have a link to that below this video. On this table, I have the things we're going to need today. Today, we're going to need some aluminum foil. I've gone ahead and cut a couple pieces here that are about 12 inches long. We're going to need something to act as our booty. So on this tray here, I have some gold coins. I have some little toys that I've collected, and I've got some marbles. So you can use anything that you have around the house. You could use some coins that you have or some little toys. You could use silverware. You could use some rocks from outside, whatever you've got going on. Over here, I have just a tub of some plain water. At home, you might want to do this in your sink or in your bathtub, or maybe go outside and do this in a bucket. That might be fun. And I've made a couple of boats, but let me show you how I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then we'll get started. So today we're talking about buoyancy. What do we need in order for a ship to float? So I've got a piece of aluminum foil here, just some basic thin aluminum foil, and I'm going to fold it into a ship. So how you want to make your ship is up to you. We might need to try a couple of attempts here. Sometimes, remember, in science, the first time is not always the right time, right? So we have to keep trying and trying until it works. I'm just folding up the edges. I'm folding them down once like this to make a crease and then up one more time. But you can make your boat however you like. Let's see how all these different boats float. I'm going to go over back to my boats over here that I've already made to show you. So this one is just like the one I was making. I just folded up the edges. I made it kind of small. So you can see it's about the same size as my hand, actually. This boat is much bigger, right? So this boat is about twice my hand. So we'll see if bigger is better or smaller. We'll see if smaller and tighter is better than this one that's kind of round. You could even just fold your aluminum foil in half and kind of see if you can make it float in the middle. But let's see. So what you want to do is put your boat into your water. So now I'm floating, and let's see how much weight this boat can hold. So I'm going to start with my gold coins. So I'm going to pick up 5 of them, and I'm going to put them in and see if my boat floats. My boat still floats. So let's see if I can put in more. What you'll want to do is keep counting your coins or your toys or your rocks or whatever it is you're using to test and see which boat that you make can actually hold the most. So here's another 10 coins. My boat is still floating. I'm going to try some marbles because those are heavier. Of course, the heavier the item is that I add, the more likely this boat is to sink. So now I have 5 marbles in my hand. I'm going to put those in gently. If I drop them in like this, it's going to be a cannonball, right? If I drop them in from up here, I want to put them into my boat. I want to load them carefully. My boat is still floating. I'm going to go ahead and add 5 more marbles. We're still floating. Let's add 5 more. And we're still floating. So you want to keep trying this out. I'll add all my little toys and see what happens. Can they all float in my boat? Oh, they can, but you can see this side is starting to sink. That's called listing. My boat is listing to one side. I don't know how much more pirate treasure I can carry back. Let's put in a handful of coins. Ooh, I don't think there's any more room for my pirates now. But if I keep putting in the coins, oh no, the coins are starting to go off the side. We're starting to get too full here. But you can see you can keep testing it. So I'm going to take this boat out, and I'm going to see if my bigger boat could hold as much. I'm going to leave all this stuff in here, and I'm just going to transfer what's in that boat into this other boat. So this boat is bigger, but I don't think it's as well made. Do you see the edges are not as tight?
So let's see what happens if I start putting all of these items from this boat into this boat. My hands are a little wet, but that's okay. So this boat's bigger, so I think maybe it can hold a little bit more, but maybe I'm just gonna put the whole boat in. Yep, this boat's still floating too. So keep trying this at home. See how much weight you can add to your boat and see which design works best for you. Happy International Talk Like a Pirate Day.